What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about how to create these really cool realistic subway tiles in Revit. Now, if you don't know about them, subway tiles, they're quite popular these days. It's these retro tiles. They're quite simple and straightforward. They look kind of like bricks. Usually they're white, but you can get them in different colors. They just have this kind of chamfered edge, and they have kind of half step to them, quite popular, and I wanted to just figure out a way to create them in 3D, so you don't create them by using a material, because that usually looks terrible. So I'm actually going to be showing you in this tutorial a really easy way to apply them in 3D, which is going to make your models a lot more realistic. And you're probably going to be using them because they are quite popular. I actually have them in my kitchen, so that's why that's how I got inspired for this tutorial. And also, you don't have to use them just for your tiles for your kitchen. You can actually use these for like facade elements, you know, those classical like block or stone facade elements. They have basically the same shape, just different dimensions, and you can control that through parameters. So you can actually use this for multiple applications, and I'm going to be showing you all of that. Now, before we get started with the tutorial, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. It's going to be the first link just below this video, in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my courses, so if you're serious about learning Revit, it's definitely a good place to kind of get started or to take you to that advanced level. I have courses covering different knowledge levels and then also different topics in Revit. So there is something for everybody there. There's over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. And also something that they've added recently is that you can actually purchase some really high quality, really detailed Revit families that can enhance your models and your renderings. So if you want to check those out there on the website as well. So check it out if you're interested. Also, before we get started, really important, make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe and click the notification bell icon. Not only because it helps you not miss any of my future tutorials, but it does make the alpaca happy, and let's be serious, that's why we're all here. Okay, so without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. Okay, and as you can see here, we are in Revit, and this is just the family that we're going to be creating. I just wanted to show you how it looks before we get started. So this is that tile. As you can see, if I zoom in here, we have these points, and then we just have kind of these offset points that kind of give us that chamfered edge, and everything's controlled through parameters. So I'm just going to be showing you how to set all of this up. It's just a curtain panel pattern based family that we then apply in Revit, and I'm just going to be showing you how to then apply this in your projects. So let me close this down. I don't want to save any of the changes, and now let's start creating our family. So you want to go here to families first, you want to go then to new, and then this is the important part, and that is choosing the correct family template. Now, what you want to go here for is the curtain panel pattern based. I'm using the metric one because I use the metric system, and if you want to use the imperial one, by all means, do that. So I'm just going to double click here and open up this family template. Now what you want to do first is just adjust this framing of the family. You can see that this one only has 4 points, and the one that they have shown you previously had 6. So what you want to do is select this frame. So you just come from the outside, when it highlights, you click, and here in the properties panel, you just want to change it from rectangle to 1/2 step. It's going to turn into something that looks like this. And also you want to change the dimensions. By default, this is usually for some facade panels, and they are usually really large, and this is actually quite small. So what you want to do is go here to horizontal spacing and change that. I'm just going to go with 300, and the vertical spacing as well. So basically this is just telling Revit how large one of these rectangles is. And now we can get started working on this family. So what you'd want to do first is zoom into the number 1 point, and then you want to place another point on top of this point. So you just want to go here to the draw panel, go to the point element, you click on the point element, and then you want to go to set work plane. So you want to go to set work plane and then select the horizontal plane of plate or on point one. So that's this one here. You click, and then you want to go here and make sure that the draw on work plane is selected. If it's here, it might give you some errors or it might mess things up. So just make sure you're always set on draw on work plane. You come in here, you click exactly on that same existing point. You click, hit the escape key a couple of times, and there you go. Now I can just select this point. And to move it up, you want to go to the properties panel and you go to offset. Now make sure you don't select the kind of original point number one. You want to go here to this one. You will see that this one, when you select it, it says reference point. And when you select this one, it says adaptive point. So that's how you can kind of tell the difference. And also this one has all of these reference planes, but that's okay. Okay, so you select that reference point, you then go to the properties, you scroll down a little bit, and here we have the offset. So for the offset, what you want to do is just give it an offset that you want to use. I want to use 30 millimeters, so I'm just going to use that, and then when you hit apply, it goes up. Now, I also want to have the ability to parametrically control this later on inside of the project. So what you want to do next is go there to that offset parameter, go to this associate family parameter option, and when you click on that, you can, well, associate a family parameter. So you can just go here to new parameter, you click, I'm just going to keep it as a type parameter, and then you can give it a name, and I'm fine with the offset. So I'm just going to call it offset, click OK, and there we go. Now we have a parameter for offset. You click OK, and there we go. Next, you want to select this point, and here you can move it like this using the green arrow and the red arrow, and you're just going to pull it towards the inside of this rectangle. Or to do it quicker, you can just grab this kind of little corner, blue corner, and it does the same thing. So just move it a little bit towards the inside like that, and then you want to control that position as well. So what you do for that is you simply go here to the quick access toolbar, you go to aligned dimension, DI is the shortcut, and then you follow this. You first select the vertical reference plane like this, and then you select the point, and then you just kind of place it here like that. You do the same thing with the other one, so with this one, and then you place it here. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Now, these dimensions might look a little bit too large at this point, so what I like to do is just change the scale so everything looks a bit more proportional. So I'm just going to go to 1 to 10. There we go, looks much cleaner. Yeah. I liked it like this. And then you want to select that dimension, hold the control key so you get that little plus sign next to your cursor, select this one as well, and now we want to turn these dimensions into parameters as well. So for that, you go here to a label, and then you can just use that offset parameter that we already have. So it's just going to give it kind of the same dimension when it comes to the height offset and when it comes to the kind of left and right offset. So it's kind of at 45 degrees from that original point, and that's what you want to have. And now you just repeat that three more times. Now I'm just going to do it once again here, and then you can kind of repeat the rest, and I'm just going to skip the rest of these. So you just go again to the point element, you go to set work plane, you set the work plane, you make sure it's drawn work plane, you click, you escape, you click the escape key a couple of times, you select the point, you go here to the properties. Now, in this case, you don't have to enter the offset. You can just go here to associate family parameter, use that offset one, click OK. So now it's up. You select it again, use the little blue thing to move it towards the inside, just like that. Zoom out, go to the align dimension, click, go from the vertical one to here, place it there, from the vertical one here to here, place it there, hit the escape key a couple of times, select both of them, label, and then offset. And there we go. And then I'm just going to skip, and I'm just going to do the same thing for the points 4 and 6. As you can see, I have now completed all 4 points, and now it's time to connect them. So you just select the first point, you hold the control key, you select the second one, and then you go to spline through points here on the draw panel. So just click on that, and it's going to connect them. And then you want to go to the properties panel, scroll down a little bit, and you have this reference or is a reference line, and then you just want to check that on. So it just turns it into a reference line. And then you just repeat that. You cannot do all 4 points at once. You have to go 2 by 2. So you just select a couple of more points, spline through points, is reference. There we go. And then you're just kind of repeat that here. Just make sure you select this point. There we go. So you're holding the control key when selecting multiple points at once, is reference. And then let's go like this, spline through points, is reference. Okay, perfect. Now, once you have this, you will see that Revit is going to connect these in a chain. So you want to select that chain of lines, hold the control key, select the bottom chain of lines. So it's going to look like this. And then you just go here to create form, you click, and then it's pretty much done. You have your subway tile. Now, obviously we can select this form, so I can just make a selection like this, like a broad selection. And then if we can go here to filter, check none, let's see, curtain panels, apply. Okay, so it's just going to select that form. Here you can assign its material. So if you want to select that, go to, I don't know, porcelain or something like ceramic tile. Let's see, ceramic, yeah. Let's see, like that. Do we have something like this? But I don't want it to have those tile lines. That's the thing. Well, this one doesn't. This one has it. Okay, so let's go with just something like this. Yeah, this could look good. Click OK. And there we go. We have assigned the material. Let's go to realistic. Okay, we have assigned that material now. And yeah, this is pretty much ready to go. So you want to save this family first, obviously. So I'm just going to go here to the save button. I'm going to save it on my desktop here. And let's call it the, I don't know, the tile family. Hit save. And now let's use this inside of a project. So I'm just going to go here to the file menu, go to new, go to project, and then here, when I choose the template file, I'm going to just choose my custom Balkan Arctic template. And if you're interested in checking out my templates, you can actually find them on my website, balkanarctic.com. It's going to be the link just below this video and then also up in the cards. So check those templates out. We have the custom Balkan Arctic template and the architecture design template. Okay, so let's go here with the custom Balkan Architect template, click OK, and that's going to start up a Revit project. Now, as soon as that happens, what we want to do is go here to the Massing and Site tab. You want to turn on Show Mass. You want to go to In Place Mass, and now let's create a simple mass wall. So let's go to Mass 1. I'm going to create a rectangle, like for a, I don't know, like a building or a wall, whatever. Go to 3D view, select that, and then you want to go to create form, and this is the form that we get. Okay, so now here you can select one of the sides of this form, and you can go to divide surface. Now what that's going to do is it's going to give us kind of a divided surface like this. And then here in the properties, you can actually adjust the U and V grids. So you can come in here and then you can just give it different options for the grids. So I like to use a fixed distance when I'm using tiles, because usually tiles are, well, fixed dimensions. And then let's set the distance to 0.3 meters as we did previously. So let's go here, 0.3 meters. We had 300 millimeters, which is basically 0.3 meters. It's going to look like this. That's perfectly fine. Also, you want to switch here. It's going to be a 1.5-step pattern, but we first have to load in our family. So let's go back to the family. Here, you go to load into project. And then inside of the project, you select that pattern again. And then here, what you want to do is just, let's see, let's actually play around with the dimensions before we do that. I'm just going to pull this out a little bit so we can have kind of fuller tiles. just a little bit further out. Okay, it's just creating a new tile here, which I don't like. Okay, same thing on top. Okay, that works. Okay, anyways, now let's go here, select again the whole mesh, go to no pattern, and then here under one step option we have the tile family. So let's assign that, wait for a few moments for Revit to do its calculations, and then this is what we get. As you can see, that family has now been assigned. And it looks really, really good. As you can see, that's what those tiles look like, and we can here switch to, I don't know, consistent colors or shaded. So it's really up to you to kind of play around with different options, but there you go. That's how you create these tiles. And obviously you can select the individual tile. So just use the tab key a few times and select the individual tile. And then you can go here to edit type and you can change that offset parameter. So you can change it from 0.3 to 0.5 if you want, hit apply. Okay, and as you can see then, that kind of step is quite larger. So now it looks more like a facade than the tile. So you can just kind of play back and forth with that parameter and adjust it the way you like. So there you go. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial and I hope you have learned something new. If you want to get this family, it's actually available on my Patreon page where I upload all of my Revit project files. So that's going to be one of the links in the description just below this video and then also up in the cards above. So check it out if you're interested. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.